Hey guys, it's Lauren and welcome back to another Where Is episode. I hope everyone is having a great day. So today's case is definitely an interesting one, so let's just get right into it. Today we will be talking about the unsolved disappearance of Teekah Lewis. Teekah was born on July 4th in 1996 to her mother Teresa and her father Robert. She was African American, Caucasian, and Native American, and she was just 2 years old when she went missing from Tacoma, Washington. Teekah was described to have had a more shy and quiet personality, and she loved eating candy, Starburst in particular being her favorite. On January 23rd in 1999, Teekah, along with about a dozen of her family members, all gathered at the New Frontier Lanes Bowling Alley, which was located on Center Street in Tacoma, Washington. This was a popular bowling alley in the area and was actually quite busy the night that Teekah and her family went, considering it was a Saturday night and I believe it was league night there as well. While they were at the bowling alley, her family rented out two lanes and Teekah was just playing in the arcade area with some of her cousins, just having fun and enjoying their night. The arcade area in the bowling alley was not far from where her family was bowling, so Teekah was only a few feet away from her family and she was about 6 feet away from the exit. While Teekah was playing in the arcade, her mother Teresa says that she was standing at the counter that was basically separating the lanes, the arcade, and the restaurant in the bowling alley from each other, so that way she could, you know, keep an eye on Teekah and the other children and still be able to watch her family bowl. At about 10:30 p.m., Teresa headed to the arcade to check on Teekah and make sure that she was okay, but Teresa couldn't find Teekah anywhere. She decided to check the bathroom to see if she was in there and looked all over the bowling alley, but she still couldn't find her. Teresa quickly told a staff member that she could not find her daughter, and within minutes, they announced on a loudspeaker that there was a 2-year-old who was missing named Teekah and asked if everyone there could be on the lookout for her. Everyone quickly stopped what they were doing to help look for Teekah. People were looking under tables, under chairs, and just around their area to see if she was there. No one could seem to find her anywhere, and that is when an employee at the bowling alley and an off-duty police officer called the police and reported her missing. Some people began to head outside to see if maybe Teekah was somewhere in the parking lot, but there was still no trace of Teekah. Now, Teekah's father was actually not in attendance that night, and that is because he was actually sentenced to 4 years in prison when Teekah was young, so that is why he was not at the bowling alley. Once police were notified of her disappearance, police brought in tracking dogs to see if they could trace her scent, but they were unable to track her scent. Police also set up a roadblock and volunteers helped search the surrounding area for almost 24 hours. Police even searched the homes of sex offenders that lived in the area, but there was still no signs of Teekah anywhere. Around the time Teekah went missing, so between 10 and 10:15 p.m., a witness who was unnamed told the police that they saw a car that was speeding out of the parking lot. The car was a maroon Pontiac Grand Am and was either a late 1980s or early 1990s model, and it had dark tinted windows with a large rear spoiler. Another witness claims to have seen a white male that seemed to be following a child that was heading towards the bowling alley's exit that night. The witness described the man as being in his 30s with brown shoulder-length hair, a mustache, a large nose, and pockmarks or craters on his face. As we know, investigators did conduct a search pretty much right off the bat for Teekah, but they were not able to determine if the person that was driving the car or the man that the other witness had seen following the child are connected to Teekah's disappearance. Now, something that is really interesting is that in November of 1998, just 2 months before Teekah disappeared, a 4-year-old boy was sexually molested in the bathroom at the same bowling alley that Teekah disappeared from, and the suspect had similar features as the man that the witness had described to police, who they believed was following a child the night of Teekah's disappearance. He was described as a white male around 30 to 40 years old, having brown curly hair and a beard. Two security guards that worked at the bowling alley said that they had seen him there before, but neither of them knew his name. Now, this story gets even more disturbing. Just a few weeks after this incident, a man with the same similar description attempted to lure a 6-year-old boy from the bowling alley, and the man claimed that the boy was actually his son. The man then quickly left the bowling alley, and there was never a police report made. Now, if all of that wasn't bad enough, on the same day that Teekah went missing, just a few hours earlier, a man with the same description was at a park that was less than a mile away from the bowling alley, attempted to kidnap 2 children who were playing at the park. Luckily, the children's father saw what was happening and he chased the man away, and the man drove off in a blue 1995 Pontiac Grand Am. The children's father didn't report the incident until 3 days later once he heard about Teekah's disappearance on the news. Out of all of the incidents that had happened, no arrests were made, and it is still unknown whether or not all of the cases are related. A few years had gone by and there were still no leads in regards to Teekah's case. In 2006, Tacoma Pierce County Crime Stoppers offered a $27,000 reward in hopes of someone coming forward with information on Teekah's whereabouts. Investigators were still receiving tips, but it seemed like the investigation had reached a standstill. That same year, however, there was a girl from Texas who had been adopted and was believed to be Teekah, but after a DNA test, it was determined that it was not her. In 2010, there was a psychic who had claimed that Teekah was no longer alive and that her body had been buried at a specific location at the Point Defiance Park in Tacoma. Investigators did excavate the area that the psychic claimed that she was at, but they didn't find anything. Just this year, police released a witness statement of a man who had attended the bowling alley the night that Teekah had disappeared. He was 17 years old at the time and was a patron of the bowling alley and was just bowling with his family. And he said that he was heading to the restroom and a man bumped into him very forcefully. He described the man to be a white male, about 5'11", long brown curly hair with pockmarks and a mustache. He said that the man was carrying a young girl who looked to be of mixed race, but he said that he simply just thought that the man was taking his daughter to the restroom. Now, the reason why the witness said that the incident stayed with him was because of how rude the man was. I mean, he literally just bumped into him and he said that he quickly walked away without even apologizing. The witness said that they saw Teekah on the news the next day, and at that moment, he knew that the girl he saw the man carrying was indeed Teekah, and that this is when he called the police. After the witness was interviewed by the police in January of 1999, he was never recontacted. 21 years later, so this year, a cold case investigator was looking through Teekah's case, which, by the way, contained thousands of pages of information. The investigator came across the statement that the witness had made about seeing a man carrying who he thought to be Teekah, and the investigator immediately knew that this statement was extremely significant to the case. The investigator contacted the witness, and the witness still remembered the man's face and him having pockmarks on his face. The investigator believed that this piece of information could potentially solve Teekah's case. As he was going through more of Teekah's file, he came across another tip. It was about a week after Teekah had disappeared, and a news crew was filming a reenactment of what happened at the bowling alley that night. There was someone there who was watching, and they noticed someone there who was also watching that had pockmarks on his face, and the witness says that the man was acting pretty strangely, but at that time, the case was obviously still fresh, and the witness wouldn't have known that someone with that description was potentially involved in the case. Detectives are still continuing their search for Teekah, and I hope with them going back through her case that they can help find the information needed to bring her home. Teekah's mother says that she just wants to bring her daughter home, and that whoever took her, she just hopes that they raised her well and took care of her, but she also feels like whoever took her specifically went to the bowling alley to find an innocent child to bring harm to them, but she still is not giving up hope. If alive, Teekah would be 24 years old. She is biracial with black hair and brown eyes. She also has a large birthmark on her left buttock and has red natural highlights in her hair. She has a few light patches of discoloration on her face due to eczema, as well as dimples and pierced ears. At the time of her disappearance, she was last seen wearing a green Tweety Bird shirt, white sweatpants, black and white Air Jordans, and her hair was up in a ponytail. She was also last seen carrying a clear purse that had a fish design and had Starburst candy in it. If you have any information at all, you can contact the Tacoma Police Department at 253-798-4721. Teekah was such a beautiful little girl, and I hope we can bring her home together. But that is it for me today, you guys. I hope everyone has a great day, and I will see you in the next one.